amount of money, silver and gold, can appease and help somebody's sin and life. Only redemption that is found in Jesus Christ. Are we together? For there's nothing that can wash away my sins. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. You remember that hymn, powerful hymn. Amen. I know this generation does not love hymns, but we thank God for our worship team. They keep, at least they give us songs with the stanzas. CO2, virudio, virudio, kurudia, rudia too. At least there are some stanzas. Huh? The bishop who was here last week, he said, I like the meat in your songs. I said, that's good. Praise God. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Amen? So, redemption. Somebody say redemption. We are just reading scripture to show you what Peter said regarding this matter of the Lamb of God. Amen? Do you remember that tradition from our fathers is referred to as aimless conduct? Do you remember that? So the conduct of slaughtering goats and lamb for family ceremonies and try to declare anything. Look at verse 19. And scripture is very clear. It compares the Lamb of God. He says, how have we been redeemed? Read aloud. 1, 2, go. With the precious blood of Christ, as a lamb without blemish and without spot. Wow. So Jesus has been mentioned, called the Lamb of God. What kind of lamb? This lamb that used to be brought in the Old Testament to the priest must be a lamb without blemish. Madoadoa. Must not have madoadoa, you know, or lameness or blindness. Come on. Anything you bring to God, that lamp used to be, it must be a pure lamp. Looking at it, miguu yake ine yote iko hapo, all the four legs, usilete kondoo ya miguu tatu. It must be seeing, it should not be blind, and should be without spot. One color, white, for instance. Amen? So the scripture is saying, we were redeemed not with corruptible things like silver or gold, rather we were redeemed, praise God, with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Look, it's called the precious blood, as a lamb. So when you hear John saying, behold the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world, we are talking about the Jesus Christ as a sacrificial lamb who was to go to the cross, and indeed he went, shed his blood on the cross, and guess what? For the remission of sins. Praise God. For the forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. The blood of Jesus. Somebody say the blood of Jesus. Now, I will tell you probably 20 things that the blood of Jesus means. But let me begin by telling you just 3 of them this morning. 3 powerful purposes of the blood of Jesus, and I think other things we shall share before Jesus returns. One of the purposes of the blood of Jesus on the cross, remember his name is Jesus. Somebody say Jesus. In Matthew 1:21, the angel said of Mary, and she shall bear a son and shall call his name Jesus, for he shall do what? He shall save his people from their sins. Matthew 1:21, praise God. He shall save his people from their sins. So the name Jesus is the name God is Savior, which is the name Hosea, which became Joshua, which became Jesus. Means God is Savior, and his name, that means his nature, his character, is that God forgives sins. Praise God. So one of the greatest purposes of the blood of Jesus is literally to forgive sins, and to not only forgive them but to wash them. Praise God. That's the first purpose and power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Let me tell you, because of the blood of Jesus, we can preach the gospel all over the world, everywhere, and tell the world that no matter how bad their lives have been, no matter how evil they have been, they could be dealing with drugs, they could be con men, all kinds of life. If they can believe in Jesus, the Lamb that went on the cross, guess what? They'll be forgiven. Their sins will be washed away. God will look at them as if they never sinned. Their lives will be turned around. I want you to carry that powerful revelation of the power of the blood of Jesus in forgiveness, because our world still need Jesus. Praise God. Go to the first letter of John, particularly John, 1 John chapter 1. We read from verse 7 and see the power of this blood of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. But if we walk in the light, the Bible says, he is in the light. We have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. Hallelujah. This is what, listen. Dawa ya dhambi ni damu. You know, some of you and some people think that because I sinned a long time ago, God has forgotten. You are a liar. No amount of time lost will take care of sin. Sin can only be taken care of by true repentance and turning to God. Useme, oh, mimi nilifanya dhambi zamani sana. Mungu nafikiri alisawa ninisame. You got to go back to that point and humble yourself before God and trust that cleansing blood of Christ by putting faith in Jesus. Listen, we put our faith in Christ, and the blood is what spiritually he releases upon us. Amen. Because without the shedding of blood, there's no what? Remission or forgiveness. I think that's Hebrews 9, 22. Because I think 9, 27 talks about death. Go to 9:22, Hebrews. I hope so. It was not part of what I was to read, but the Holy Ghost sometimes helps us to read scripture. There it goes. According to the law, almost all things are purified with what? With blood. And without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. To remit, to forgive. There is no, without blood. So listen, if your life is in a mess, the only thing you can do is not to run away. Because even if you go to another church and the man of God there is a very good motivator, it doesn't matter. You may be going through stuff, all that kind of nonsense. Listen, the only thing that can wash away your sins is the blood. Go back to 1 John, chapter 1, verse 7. And verse 8, the Bible says what? If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. Verse 9. And if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and also to do something else. You know, the work of the blood is to cleanse. It's like soap. Oh my God. The work of the blood is to do what? Is to cleanse. It's like soap. I like a little illustration that Reinhard Bonnke used to give in 1988 when he came to Uhuru Park. And Mutuku Fries Moi gave KBC 4 p.m. for live television. And Brandon Bonke preached for 7 days. I think there were 7 days live. I tell you, Kenya was saved. Some of the men who were saved that time, today they are bishops. I know one of them. Amazing. And he used to give, oh, this story, you may have soap in your house and in the bathroom, but unless you remove your clothes, take the soap, let the water run, you will still be dirty and smelling. And he said, the blood of Jesus is there. You got to apply the blood. And your sins will be washed. It is still true even today. Tell your neighbor, it's still true even today. What can wash away the sins of humanity? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. So, the first thing the blood does is to remit sins or deal with forgiveness and cleansing. Praise God. There's a second thing that the blood of Jesus does. We go to Hebrews chapter 9 again. We'll read a couple of scriptures just for the purpose of, from verse 11, purpose of context, and then four verses just to see the picture. But Christ came as a high priest of the good things to come with a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation. So, not with the blood of goats and calves. You see, high priest, somebody say high priest. The high priest came to sacrifice using animals, goats and lambs and so forth. Now, so this time Christ has not come with the blood of goats and calves, but he has come with what? With his own blood. He entered the most holy place once and for all, having obtained eternal redemption. So while the priest used to go to the tabernacle and go to the Holy of Holies, once a year to sacrifice, the Bible is comparing here, saying Christ Jesus went in as a high priest, but this time not to return next year. He did it once and for all, for what the Bible is calling to obtain eternal redemption. It's what is called atonement. Somebody say atonement. Atonement, to atone. Atonement is a word you can break like this. At one moment. He went in once and for all. And whatever he did on the cross was once and for all. In fact, there's no other sacrifice that needs to be done now. Jesus has finished that operation. Praise God. But let's read on. Verse 13. The Bible says, for if the blood of bulls and goats and the ashes of heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctifies for the purifying of the flesh. You see, they did that. They took the blood of bulls and goats and all that, and the priest would do stuff for the sanctifying of the flesh and so forth, and say they are okay now. How much more? Somebody say, how much more? How much more what? The blood of Christ. Shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God. You see, he was a lamb. Do you remember the other lamb was without spot and blemish? Jesus did not have any sin, did not have any defect. He was holy, the Son of God, without spot to God. So how much more with that blood of Christ cleanse your what? Your conscience from dead works to serve the living God. There it is. The second purpose of the blood of Jesus is to deal with cleansing your conscience. Cleansing your conscience. What does that mean? How many of you know that there are some types of sins you used to do, and if you have not engaged the word of God like we are teaching, you're still feeling guilty in your conscience. And the devil is very cunning. He uses guilt to send guilt as an arrow in your mind to show you how bad and how terrible you are, to cause you to doubt what Christ has done for you. This morning I declare to you that the word of God says that the blood of Jesus is able to cleanse an evil conscience. So that what is dead, what is past, what was forgiven, what was cleansed, what God delivered you from, what you are separated from, has no more right to stand before God and before you now. It's gone, it's over, it's finished. Jesus has released the power of the blood. You are taken care of in your mind. The guilt is taken care away. Let me tell you, unless the blood cleanses the guilt, you will forever continue to be tormented by the devil. But today there is power in the blood of Jesus. to deal with every guilt. Amen. If the devil tries to bring up something that Jesus has taken care of, remind him that it was taken care of by the blood, and you are no longer guilty. Praise God. You have been justified freely by the grace of God through the redemption that is found in Christ Jesus. Go to the scripture we're going to be back. Go to Romans 3 verse 23 and 24. The Bible says in Romans 3, 23, "For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God." 24. Next verse. "Being justified freely." So all those who had sinned and had were far away from God's glory, what has happened to them now in Christ? They have been justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ. Somebody say redemption. Redemption is the act of paying the price on your behalf using the most expensive price that could ever be, and that is the blood of Jesus Christ. So Jesus redeemed us by providing his own precious blood. I sense the glory of God. Right now I just sense demons and devils. I've seen them in the spirit. They have just been slapped. I saw several demons have just been slapped. Shut their mouth, my God, because of the blood of Jesus. We were redeemed. The price was paid. Hallelujah. There's no sin too deep that the Lord cannot forgive and cleanse. Amen. But you have a responsibility, ladies and gentlemen, to repent. Not only repent, but also trust in the cleansing power of the blood of Jesus, particularly to deal with the conscience. Remove the guilt conscience, praise God. May that cleansing take place in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, I told you the story of one lady who came to me in the early 20s. And she said 10 years before, she had committed an abortion. And the father never knew, who was an evangelist father. They went to Ethiopia, came back, did some things strange. She conceived. She was so scared. Organized with a boyfriend. What a story in the church. These things should not even be mentioned. And there was an abortion. Unfortunately, it's a reality of life. For 10 years, when she showed up, she said, "It's 10 years ago, but I can't help. I'm still guilty for 10 years. I said, because her conscience was still having trouble. And she said, "Man of God, what can I do? When I go to heaven, will I see my baby?" I said, "I'm not sure, but all babies belong to God." But that's another story. She said, "Please pray for me." It was my first time to handle such a case. So I said, "Give me one day." I went to pray. I asked the Lord, "What can be done for such a situation?" And the Holy Spirit reminded me, amazing scripture. I went to that scripture to look at it. Wow. It's John 20, verse 21. John 20, 21. This is what it says. There's a lot of deliverance about to take place in this service right now. A lot of things about to happen right here. Jesus said to them, "Peace be to you, as my Father sent me, so I send you." Amawatuma 22. And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive you the Holy Ghost. You have been sent, now you have the Holy Ghost. What will you do with the sending and with the Holy Ghost?" 23. "And if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. And if you retain the sins of any, they are retained." My God, hold there. So, is God saying that he has given me authority to forgive people? Yes. So the Holy Ghost spoke to me that it all depends on what we want to do to the lady. I called another man of God. We met her and we said, "We can choose ili wefunzo kwako. Not to forgive you." But we have not been given that commission. We have been given the commission to forgive you. So we stood right there on her knees. We prayed for her and we said, "Lord Jesus, forgive her and cleanse this guilt conscience because of your blood, because of our confession and of our humility. And you who sees the heart can see that is genuine repentance, which a man of God cannot see." Look at your neighbor and say, "Only God can see what's going on in your heart." If you genuinely do it from your heart, then there will be forgiveness. And that lady was forgiven and it was over. Guilt conscience was cleansed. I pray for you today that anything that has been taken care of by God shall not show up in your life anymore. Don't give an opportunity, don't give any foothold to the devil to come and harass you and remind you of how you used to smoke, how you used to do whatever. If you are born again and you love Jesus and you have given yourself, committed yourself to Christ, may you now move on and get delivered and repent and turn away from this dead works. That's a whole subject in the discipleship class, the foundational and discipleship foundational course. Repentance from dead works is a whole 1 month course. That's why we are encouraging you to go to that class. Praise God. Now, so the blood of Jesus, number one, deals with forgiveness, and number two, it deals with what? Cleansing of the guilt and dealing with the conscience. Thirdly, the blood of Jesus deals with accusations of the devil. Go to Revelation chapter 12 and verse 11. Revelation 12, verse 11. First of all, yeah. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, and they did not love their lives to death. Now they overcame him. Maybe if we read from verse 10, you would have understood who is this him. So then I heard a loud voice saying from heaven, now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ have come. For the accuser of who? Somebody say the accuser. Who accuses them before God day and night has been cast down. Hold there. Do you know Satan is an accuser? In fact, the other day we learned that prayer should be viewed as a case in court. And why many of you are being defeated is because Satan has brought an accusation as a prosecutor in court before God, and he has accused you. But you must respond. If you don't respond, you are just crying. Oh, nimeberewa kotini, oh, case in here next week, oh. And you are not using the advocate, who is a helper, Paracletos, Holy Spirit, to come and argue your case before the court. God is a just God, and he will rule according to the facts and according to precedent. He is an accuser. And there are many accusations the devil always brings before God against the children of God. And let me tell you, this is something that continues throughout. And let me encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, walk in wisdom that you don't join the accusation party, Satan accusation ministries, to accuse other brethren. Because some of you like talking behind the doors, behind the back, to talk against so-and-so, and so-and-so, and so-and-so, to bring accusations. And let me tell you, those things are very demonic. Don't join the accuser of the brethren. How many of you wamekubali kutoka leo, hamta accuse mtu yoyote? He accuses them day and night. And we talked about this some time ago. Breaking the power of accusation. This is how it works. Accusation, the opposite of accusation is intercession. God is looking for men and women who can pray, intercede for God's will to be done on the earth. God is looking for two or three who can pray to the Father, come into agreement, and ask God to do something about the church, about the family, about the ministry, about an individual. So God is looking for people who can agree with him, praise God, who can come through the confidence of the word to come before the Father and pray that God's will can be done for your life. Those who are praying and interceding for you are doing the right work because grace is being released to help you move forward in life. But on the opposite side, there are accusers led by the devil and some foolish brethren who come against the brethren and they begin to agree and you got gossiping and accusation and so forth. And that talk is soulish, is earthly, is sensual, is demonic. It's not wisdom from this world. It's from, it's not his wisdom from God. It's from the world. Listen, and when they accuse, they release something soulish, something demonic. And that what they release is something like witchcraft. It causes people to go down. The other day, we were praying with a family in our house because the woman has been sick for a year. From this sickness to this sickness to this sickness to this sickness, they get out of that surgery. I said, come to our house. We went into a prayer for 15 minutes to storm in the spirit, to ask what is what? Who is eating who? What did this woman do? Why are things the way they are? Bang! And as we were praying, the Holy Ghost spoke to me. He said, accusation from brethren. Oh my God. Kaya. May your mouth never be used. Kapasha. So what did we do? I brought a brief teaching on breaking the power of accusations. And then we said, you need to forgive those who accuse you. But remember, as you forgive them, you also need to repent because no one is innocent. Even us, we have been involved in accusing others. So you repent on both ends. And when you do that, guess what you have done? You have neutralized the accuser's presentation before God. Because Satan is a lawyer. You have neutralized the prosecutor. Then you have come and you have said, first of all, I have no right to come here, but because of the blood of Jesus, I now enter by the blood. And I have forgiven and I also repent. Then Satan as a lawyer is now demoralized. 3,000 pages of ICC, they are finished. With one blood of Jesus, one drop is enough. Praise God. And then now you can, by the help of the Holy Spirit, we now made our case before God. We said, Father, now that she has repented, now that we have also forgiven, there's no legal right to make the devil show up in this case anymore. So by the blood of Jesus, we ask you, Father, it's our prayer, release our client. Kayapa. Case dismissed, Kayuma, with the costs. And the cost is the blood of Jesus. Case dismissed with the cost, the blood of Jesus. And that woman was healed.